Number system. So we are starting with the number system. This chapter, real numbers, we have to study. So first, number system. Someone's mic is... Okay. So we are starting with the number system chapter, first chapter. In this, first thing you need to know, that is a real numbers. All the number systems will come under two types of numbers, that is real numbers and imaginary numbers. Imaginary part we are not learning right now, so only we are going through the real numbers. So now, what do you mean by real numbers? Till now, you have gone through the types of number systems, that is you have learned natural numbers, whole numbers, rational numbers. You have done earlier till now in class 6 and 7, you have gone through the natural numbers, whole numbers, all the processes about the natural and whole numbers you have done. Fractions you have learned, and then after in class 8 you have gone to you got to know that is that fractions numbers we generally call them as a rational numbers. Okay, so till rational numbers you have learned. So rational numbers will come under the real numbers. So real numbers are further divided into two types. That is, one is a rational number and the second one is irrational numbers. So till now you have learned everything about the rational numbers, but some part is missing that we are covering this time right now in class 9, and most part of irrational numbers we are learning this time. So what are irrational numbers, how to identify them, which numbers are considered as irrational numbers, all of the and the processes related to irrational numbers we are learning this year. Okay. So starting with rational numbers are further divided. The types of rational numbers further you know. Those we divide them as natural numbers, whole numbers. So all these are rational numbers. Again, integers are the parts of rational numbers. So first, what do you mean by rational numbers? Anyone can try. Ankita, can you try?
Ma'am, what?
Rational numbers. What do you mean by rational numbers?
The number in the form of P by Q where Q is not equal to 0 is known as a rational number.
Okay. The number which is written in the form P by Q, that means we are able to write them in the form of P by Q. That means in the form of fraction. We can mention them. Every number, suppose we are taking the number 1, so 1 also can be written as 1 by 1. 0 if you consider, then 0 also can be written as 0 by 1. 5 by 2, minus 5 by 2, 7, 3 by 2. So here everything, when we are able to write any number in the form of fractions, where the denominator of the fraction should not be 0, then those numbers we call as rational numbers. One more criteria the rational number should satisfy, that is every rational number should be written in the simplest form. So every fraction when we write, that should be written in the simplest form. That means the HCF of P and Q should be equal to 1. So rational numbers are always written in the simplest form. If you write 20 by 25, we generally don't call it as, we have to convert this into the simplest form. So this is 4 by 5. Now 4 by 5 is considered as an actual rational number. So here HCF of 4 and 5, that means here there should not be anything common between those two numbers other than 1. The only common factor between the numerator and denominator should be 1. Then those numbers we call as rational numbers. So natural numbers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, everything we can write in the form of P by Q, that is in the form of fraction. So if it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 can be written as 1 by 1, 2 can be written as 2 by 1, 3 can be written as 3 by 1, 4 can be written as 4 by 1. So all these are can be written in the form of P by Q, where the denominator is not equal to 0. So it is a rational number. Then integers. Suppose we will take minus 3. So minus 3 is a negative integer, but we can write this as minus 3 by 1. So it is a rational number. Minus 7 by 2. So not 2, it is 1. Minus 7 can be written as minus 7 by 1. So therefore it is a rational number. Okay, where Q is not equal to 0 and the common factor between them is only 1. Then all those numbers we call as rational numbers. Clear? Now this is a one criteria to know that these are the rational numbers. Rational numbers that the number should be written in the form of P by Q, which can be written in the form P by Q, and where denominator, that is Q, should not be zero. And the third criteria it should satisfy, that is HCF of numerator and denominator should be one. That means there should not be any common factor between them. So this criteria is also considered as P and Q should be co-primes. So the meaning is same. Co-prime numbers means the numbers in which the common factor is only one. There is no any other common factor between P and Q. So though 4 is not a prime number, but 4 and 7, when we consider, there is no common factor between 4 and 7. So therefore, 4 by 7 is also considered as a rational number. Okay. Now there is another criteria is there to check about the decimal numbers. This is what you have learned about the earlier normal numbers, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, and fractions you have considered. So fractions are also rational numbers. Okay. But there is few more criteria are there to consider anything as a rational. And now what do you mean by irrational? So for finding out the irrational numbers, you need to know the decimal expansion of the numbers. So decimal expansions. Now we have to learn further the decimal expansions. Then only we'll get to know about the rational and irrational numbers. Okay, so after knowing the decimal expansion, you will get to know about the rational and irrational properly. Irrational numbers I can explain you only after knowing the decimal numbers. One second. Ria is there? No. Is there Ria with any other name? With the name Redmi, who is there? May I know? Okay, fine. So, decimal expansion. Decimal values. Or we consider as a decimal expansions. Decimal expansions are of three types. One is called terminating decimal. Terminating decimals. Okay. So now what do you mean by terminating decimal? That means when we divide a fraction, that is P and Q, when we divide P with Q, after some decimal points, the number, the remainder becomes zero. So if you consider the example of 2 by 5, so now when you divide 2 with 5, so when we divide 2 with 5, so this is 2 is not divisible by 5, so therefore we'll take 0 and then decimal point. After decimal point, we take the 0. So 20 divided by 5, that is 4s are 20, so subtract, you'll get the remainder 0. So that means here, after one decimal place, the remainder becomes 0. So after that, we are not supposed to do further division. So here itself, division ends. So division ends because the remainder 0. So this kind of a decimal expansion, that is 0.4, here the division ends. So then the number terminates. So this number terminates after 0.4. After 4, the number terminates. So this kind of decimals we call as terminating decimals. Another example we can take it is 1 by 8. Okay, 1 by 8, divide 1 with 8, 0.10 it is there. So 8 ones are 8, it's 2, 20, again we are taking the 0, 8 twos are 16, 4, then again 1 0, so 8 fives are 40. So here, after 3 decimal places, answer is 0.125. After taking 5 quotient, the remainder becomes 0. So therefore, here the decimal end, the division ends. So this kind of a decimal expansion where we got the division and that now division ends here. So after 125, there is no number further will come. So that means the expansion ends here. So this kind of a decimal expansions we call as terminating. It gets terminated. It gets ended. It ended. So therefore, this kind of a decimal expansions we call as terminating decimals. It's clear. Now the second type is the type of decimal. When we keep dividing, it will keep on going. It will not end because we are not getting zero as a remainder. So then, Nishila, can you mute your mic?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So for example, see, example 1/3. So when we divide 1 with 3, what will happen? 1 dividing with 3. So it is 0. Then point, then it will become 0. 3 3s are 9. Subtract 1 we got again. We have to take 0. 3 3s are 9. Again we got as a remainder 1. Again when we take 0, then it will become 10. Again it is 3 3s are 9. So every time we keep on doing it, we are always getting 1 as a remainder. It will not end up. We are not getting any time 0 as a remainder. So here the same number is keep on repeating. One thing happened, that is this division won't end because every time till whatever the numbers we keep on dividing, we are always getting the 1 as a remainder. So that means it won't get terminated because we are not getting the remainder 0. So this kind of a decimal expansions we call as non-terminating decimal expansions. And in non-terminating, there is again factorization is there. So we have to categorize them. Here you can see the same number 10 is get a remainder, we are always getting 1. So we have to take 10 and we have to keep increasing. We are dividing with the same number. So it is 10. Again, we are getting 1. So that means here decimal expansion, when you see, it is coming 0.33333. It is so on going on. So this kind of a decimal expansion we call as non-terminating. And one more thing you have see here, that is the same number is keep on repeating. Same number 3 is keep on repeating. So this kind of a non-terminating expansions are called as non-terminating but repeating. Not terminating but repeating, or we call it as recurring. Repeating, or the another word used in a book is recurring. So the decimal expansion is non-terminating because it won't end anytime. It will keep on going on further. And as well as it is the number, the same number are keep on repeating. So such terminating, decimal expansions are called as non-terminating but repeating. Okay. So another criteria for decimal expansion, that is non-terminating but repeating or recurring. This is another criteria. And the third one is, one more type of a decimal expansions are there. So that is a non-terminating and non-recurring. The third type is non-terminating and non-repeating. This kind we are not able to get by division. Normal division way we cannot get it. If you remember last time remember the long division for finding square roots. Tanya, do you remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so start dividing with this, finding the square root of 2. So it is 2, after that decimal point, and we increase the number of zeros so that we have to find the square root of it. Now here 2, nearby is the square of 1 is only present. 1, here we are adding 1. This is 2 and this is 1. Then we'll give decimal point. Then 0, 0. Two zeros, we have to take it down. Now, near 2, which number lies? 24 fours, right? With the same number you are multiplying. It's a value 4. Then it is 96, subtract, you will get 4, and here you will get 28. Then again two more zeros, and check with 28, after that one number, and with the same number you have to multiply, it will be 1, so you're multiplying with 1, so 281, 1's up, because 282 into 2 will go up beyond 400, so we are not taking 282, 281 will only work out. So here, we have to add this side, 282, here we have to subtract, so it will be 1119, again two more zeros, and here it is 2823, 3's a 3 to the 6, it is very close, lesser value, 2824 into 4, let's try, 16, 8, 9, 32, 3, 4, 8 to the 12, 11, 11 to 96 is closer. So it is 4. We'll write the 4 here. So we'll get 11296 plus 4 this side and subtraction other RHS. So it is 704. We'll get it at 7604. Sorry. So it is 2828. Now further, if we keep on going, keep on doing this. We will see that we will not end with any number zero. So there is no time, none of the places we will get zero as a remainder. So that means this square root finding value, this long division will keep on increasing, keep on going. So here the number will keep on increasing. So this way, this kind, here also we got the square root of 2 as a decimal expansion, 1.414. One more term I will find out, then only you'll get to know exactly what I want to tell you. Then 002828. So it is 2, I think so. 4, 16, 5, 16, 5, 5, 6, 5, 6, 4. 2828, 3 into 3. I don't think so it will work. So it is 8. It is more than 6, so it is not working. So it is will work with only 2. So here we will get 2. We got the number 56564, and this is addition of 2. So here, what are the difference we will get? We will not get any time zero number. The remainder cannot be zero. But here you can see now the number 4 is repeated. The 4 is a repeated, but after 4 there is a 1. And after first 4 there is a 1 is a digit, but after second 2 is coming. So that means though one number is repeated, but the same sequence is not repeated. Here it is 4141 and here is 42. After that, when you keep on going on, you will see that is the single digit is get repeated, but not in a proper sequence. So such decimal expansions we call as non-terminating, because it won't get terminated. We are not getting any time zero as a remainder. And as well as the same sequence is not getting repeated. So repetition means, here we have seen repetition. Here a single digit get repeated. There are other examples, that is the sequence get repeated. 256, 256, 256, so on. So here the three digits, 256, 256, is getting repeated. So this will come under non-terminating but recurring, because the sequence of three digits is keep on changing, keep on repeating. But in this case, what happened? Here, though four comes, but the sequence is not get repeated. We are not getting 41414 always. So here, next number only, the fourth digit when we see, after four, the two comes. That means the number get repeated, but the sequence of the numbers are not getting repeated. So such decimal expansions we call as non-terminating and non-repeating. It's not getting repeated. Okay, so this kind of a decimal expansions are non-terminating and non-repeating. Got to know the three types of decimal expansions. First one is terminating. First one we have seen, that is a terminating decimals. Second one we have seen, if it is not terminating, if it is not, that means it is non-terminating. And in non-terminating also there are again categorization. One is repeating digits and another one is non-repeating digits. Yes, Vedang, any doubt?
Yes, ma'am. Doubt means Now 0.333, that decimal is non-terminating but recurring.
Yeah.
And 0.125 is terminating,
Yes.
So these are the names of the decimals,
types of decimals.
Okay.
So here what happened in 0.125, after 5, the division cannot get continuation because the division becomes 0. So if we continue, we are getting every time 0000 only. Okay. So that means the number is 0.125. After that division ends. So therefore, we call it as terminating. But in case of 1 by 3, what happened? When we keep on doing it, the remainder we are not getting 0. Every time the remainder we are getting 1.
Yeah.
Okay. So here the anytime we are not able to end up, we are not getting 0 to end it up.
Yes. We are getting 1.
Non-terminating. Yes. And after non-terminating, what happened? The number in a quotient, 3-digit, is keep on repeating. So this kind of decimal expansions are called as non-terminating but repeating. Okay, it won't terminate, but the digits repeat. In another example, I've shown you 0.256256256. Everyone, please mute your mic. Please mute your mic. Who is asking question? There's only unmute. After muting also, you are able to get my voice.
Yes.
Shishila, please mute your mic. Anif, can you mute your mic?
Yes, ma'am.
Because much more noise is backside, so I'm getting only noise. Everyone are getting back. Even Rupam. So I'm not able to continue because much more disturbance is backside. Anif, thank you. Or you can go to a silent room anywhere if it is not able to mute. Okay. Fine. So is it clear? What do you mean by terminating and what do you mean by non-terminating decimals?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now it is repeating part clear?
Yes.
Now one more thing in a repeating part is a single digit may repeat it. Or maybe the multiple digits in a sequence of digits also getting repeated. So that means I've shown you example here. I will show you more examples. So here 0.333. So here single digits get repeated. Sometimes what happens, this is 0.23232323. It is getting repeated. So that means a sequence of two digits. 23, 23, 23, 23. So two digit sequence getting repeated. So this is also possible. Sometimes what happens? 3 digits. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 is keep on repeating. First it will come 1, 2, 3. Again the same one will come, and after that this sequence of 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 get repeated. So this will also come under non-terminating but repeating terms. So repetition doesn't mean only one digit get repeated. Maybe the combination of 2 digit also get repeated, combination of 3 digit also get repeated, or maybe the combination of 6 digit also get repeated. I will show you the example of 6 digit. So see here, we have to find the value of 1/7. Start dividing with 7. 7, 1, you have to start dividing with 7. What will happen first? 0, point. Now 10, 7 ones are 7, remainder is 3, 30. 7 fours are 28. That's 2, 20. 7 twos are 14. 6 is the remainder. 16. Then again it is 7, 8 is 56, 4, 40. Now 7, 5 is 35, remainder is 5, again 50. So it becomes 7, 7 is 49. So it will come 1. Now 1, which is present
again.
Beginning, 1 got it. Now make it
10. Yeah.
What you will get? 7, 1 is 7, remainder is 3.
The cycle will continue.
Yeah. So here again, 3 got. Now 30. So 7, 4 is 28. Remainder 2, 20. 7, 2 is 14. 60. 7, 8 is 56. 4, 40. Now here again, I will come back this side. Now 40 divided by 7. That means it is 7. 5 is 35. This is 5, 50, 7, 7 is a 7, 7 is a 49. Again, I got 1. So, 4 sequence came back again. So, you can see that this decimal expansion is 0.28571425. So, and after that, again, it will come 1. We got. So, now this sequence of 1, 2, 8, 5, 7. So that means the 6 numbers. Repeated after from the 7th term. From the 7th number, the sequence is again repeated. So, now here now digits get repeated. So, therefore, and it never ends because we are not getting any time 0 as a remainder. So, therefore, here this kind of expansion we call as non-terminating.
But repeating.
But repeating. Is that clear now? Non-terminating and repeating means what?
Yes.
Here always don't consider that is a single digit get repeated. The sequence of digits, that means a one digit, two digit, three digit, four digit, five digit, six digit also, keep on repeating after that many numbers. So this kind of a sequence we call as, this kind of expansions we call as non-terminating and non-repeating. So these are the different possible expansions. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Non-terminating and non-repeating. One of the example I shown you, root 2. If you check it for root 3 also, root 5 also, root 7, root 6, root 8, anything if you keep on finding out, you will always get that is a decimal expansion will be non-terminating. That means it won't get terminated. We are not able to get the remainder 0. So therefore, the sequence is this one. That division is keep on going on. So it never ends.
So it will happen for the square root of any non-square number.
Yes. So that is what I want to tell you. So here, this sequence will keep on repeating because we are not getting remainder 0. And also what happens, another thing is the digits, the single digit keep on repeating, but the sequence is not proper. The sequence is not same. One second, exactly I will tell you the value of root 2. One second, the full value of root 2. I can explain you the values. One second. I will show you the value of root 2, exact value of root 2. There are many decimal places. This is the value of root 2 is 1.414123560 2350 4880 4888 7242 0 96. And keep on happening. Now you can see this is after how many decimal places we have calculated answer. But here the numbers are there. See here 4 is present. Now here also 4 is present. Here is also 4 is there. But can you say anywhere that is the same sequences get repeated?
No.
is it?
No.
No. Trishila, can you see? Trishila, can you see?
Yes, I can.
So here you can see that is it is not getting terminated. And see, again thing is that the numbers are keep on repeating, but the numbers are there, but not the proper sequence is not get repeated. So this kind of expansion we call as non-terminating
and
non-repeating also. Is that clear now, difference between all these three types of decimal expansion? Now clear? Now one more thing, take the value of pi. You know what is pi?
Yes.
22/7.
Daphne? What is pi?
22/7.
We have taken one value, but actually that is the approximated value we have taken. Actually, value of pi is 3.14 15592 6535 8979 3268 4626 23 4626 43 actually. This is 43 3832 7950 so on. So one approximated value of pi we have taken as 22/7. But 22/7 is not the full value of pi. Pi value is this actually, which is again non-terminating as well as non-repeating. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So there are these ways, there are three types of decimal expansions. Now in that, the first two we have seen. Now we have seen these three types. One is one decimal expansion is terminating. Second one we have seen non-terminating,
but repeating.
And the third one we have seen non-terminating and non-repeating. Okay. Out of these three, now we have, there are the categorization among rational numbers and irrational numbers. We have seen that is rational numbers are of the form P by Q, where Q is not equal to zero, and P and Q should be co-prime numbers. So those we have categorized under rational numbers. And irrational numbers, that is in a real numbers, there is only two parts are there. One is rational and another one is irrational. So if any number is not rational, then it is considered under irrational. So that means a number which cannot be written in the form P by Q. So all those numbers are considered as irrational numbers. But this criteria is not so definite. So how we can say this example for that is the decimal expansion. These decimal expansions. Non-terminating and non-repeating numbers we are not able to write, that means the square root of any non-perfect square, that is square root 2, or the value of a pi, we cannot write in the form of P by Q form. Therefore all these values are considered under irrational numbers. And the best criteria to check whether the number is rational or irrational, that is their decimal expansions. If a decimal expansion is terminating, then it is a rational number, because only rational numbers are converted into terminating decimals. We will get, for the rational numbers we can get the decimal expansion as terminating, as well as for non-terminating and non-repeating numbers, or also can be written in the form of P by Q. We have written 1/3, which is non-terminating as well as repeating, 1/7, which is non-terminating but repeating. So they are written in the form of P by Q. So therefore, these are also categorized under rational numbers. And only the last criteria, that is non-terminating and non-repeating numbers, these cannot be written in the form of P by Q. So therefore, these are considered as all irrational numbers. So the irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be written in the form P by Q. So therefore, their decimal expansions cannot be terminating or cannot be non-terminating but repeating. So how are they? Non-terminating and non-repeating. So whose decimal expansion is non-terminating and non-repeating? All of those numbers we consider under irrational numbers. So one criteria is non-terminating but non-repeating. And whose decimal expansion we are getting like this? Those are actually the square root non-perfect square. Square root of non-perfect squares. So the number square root of A is should be a non-perfect square. That means square root of 2, square root of 3, square root of 5, square root of 6, square root of 7, square root of 17, square root of 101, square root of 102, anything. Whenever we get the square root of all these numbers, why we are saying them as irrational numbers? Because the decimal expansion of all these numbers are non-terminating as well as non-repeating numbers. So all these numbers will come under irrational numbers. Clear? Now, not only the square root, the cube roots also, the fourth roots also, fifth roots also. If we find out the cube root of 2, when we are able to find out, we are not, you have not learned that one, so I'm not explaining you that much properly. But you need to know that is cube root of 2, if we are supposed to find out, cube root of 3, cube root of 4, cube root of 5, these also have the decimal expansions, non-terminating as well as non-repeating. So all these terms will also come under irrational numbers. Clear?
Yes.
So rational numbers means the decimal expansion of whose are terminating, and if it is non-terminating, it should be repeating. Then all those decimal expansions or numbers will come under rational numbers. But the numbers whose decimal expansions are non-terminating as well as non-repeating, all those numbers will come under irrational numbers. It's clear?
Yes.
Is this part clear? Which the numbers which we consider as irrational numbers and which we have to consider as irrational numbers? For that, we have to check their decimal expansions. So we will take the examples. First, note it down. All these points, note down. From the beginning, from this point. Part, this part completed? Can I scroll down? Rupam, have you written down? at this point write down. So definition of rational number, the numbers which can be written in the form P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0 and P and Q should be coprimes. And then decimal expansions. Terminating decimals. In a division, we get a remainder 0. Then that kind of a decimals are called as terminating decimals. Write the example. First example is 2 by 5. Second example I have shown you 1 by 8. Do those division and show it.
Yeah, have you finished?
Yes, ma'am.
You can unmute your mic.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Aditya?
Yes, ma'am.
Ankita, Amrita, have you finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Amrita. Tejasvi, Pranjal, have you finished this part? Pranjal, have you finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Non-terminating but recurring. Remainder cannot be zero, but the same number is repeated. Now the same number is repeated. Then that kind of a decimal expansion we call as non-terminating but recurring. Write the example of 1 by 3 and even show the example of 1 by 7. Show the 1 by 7 also. Okay, the third type, non-terminating and non-repeating. Anurag, is this part clear? Anurag? This part is clear? The types of decimals. Anurag, can you hear me? Daphne?
Yes, ma'am.
You got to know this? This concept is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Rupika? Rupika, is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Chandana? Is this clear? Okay. Fine, write down this and then finally this part. Just finally this part. completed this part?
Yes, ma'am.
So there is a question, classify the following numbers as rational or irrational. The first number is square root 23. Rubam, can you tell square root 23, rational or irrational number? Rubam? Rubam? Unmute your mic.
Okay. Ma'am. Yeah. I'll just tell it, ma'am.
Okay. 23 is rational or irrational number?
Irrational, ma'am.
Irrational number. How?
Ma'am, because...
Yes, now I have written the number idea, if you remember. No, square root of non-perfect squares. So root 23 is a not a perfect, oh. It is a perfect number. So how you have guessed? Irrational? Just a guess.
Yeah.
Oh. It should not be. Square root of 23. Here is a condition we have written. So write down the condition to say any number as rational and irrational. So rational is, if it is a decimal expansion, then it should be terminating. Or second one, it is non-terminating, but repeating. And other than this, any natural number, whole numbers, integers, will come under rational numbers. An irrational number, two criteria. First one is square root of non-perfect square. And the second one is decimal expansion, non-terminating as well as non-repeating. Okay, so these are the criteria to identify whether it is a rational number or irrational number. Here square root 23, in that 23 is not a square of any number. Not perfect square means what? Square, that number should not be a square of any other number. So 23 is not a square of any number, so therefore it is irrational. Because it is a square root of non-perfect squares. Then next, Tejasvi, can you tell the next question? It is square root of 225. Tejasvi, can you tell me the square root of 225? Whether it is a rational or irrational number?
Rational.
Was that?
Me.
I, Rupam. Okay. Pranjal? Square root of 225, is it rational or irrational?
It's rational.
It's rational. Why it is rational?
Because it is a perfect square.
225 is a perfect square of whose?
15.
Oh, sir.
15.
Rational.
15.
15 is rational. So it is a square root of 225 is a square of 15. Therefore, square root of 225 is 15. So 15 is a natural number. So therefore, it is a rational number. Okay. Next number is 0.3796. Shreya, can you tell this number? Rational or irrational?
Mom, I'm doing.
No need to do anything in this one. You have to only identify. This is a decimal number. Which type of a decimal expansion is this?
Irrational.
It is terminating or non-terminating?
Non-terminating.
Huh?
Non-terminating.
There is any dot, dot, dot. Can you see? So it is only 0.3796. After that, anything is there?
No, ma'am.
That means it is?
Irrational.
Terminating. Is get terminated. We are not shown any dot, dot, dots. Non-terminating numbers are always written with dots. If it is written like 3796 and dot after that, it is shown. So this dot means it is keep going on. The dot, 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 we are using it for keep repeated numbers. Numbers keep on going on further. So we have not written all the things. So this kind, when it is written, then these are called non-terminating.
Okay, ma'am.
So now here, after this, nothing is dot, no dots are there. That means this is terminating number. And terminating numbers are?
Rational
numbers.
Rational. So this is a rational number. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? The next number is? Trishila?
Yes, ma'am.
7.478478 dot dot dot.
Non-terminating, so it is non-rational. I mean,
not all, rational. All non-terminating are not irrational. If it is non-terminating, then you have to check whether it is a repeating or not repeating.
Not repeating.
So it is, see, it is 4 comes after that.
7.
4, 7, 8. After that 4 is there here first again. We got the 7 again.
Yes, ma'am.
And again same 8 is repeated.
It is not terminating but repeating.
But
so repeating. It is again a rational number.
Yes. So it is non-terminating rational. Because it is dot, dot, dots are written after the numbers. That means it is non-terminating. But we can see that is 478 is repeated.
Oh.
It is repeating. So digits, 3 digits are getting repeated. So therefore it is repeating and non-terminating but repeating numbers are?
Rational numbers.
Rational numbers. So this is a rational number. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Rupika, next number. 1.10, 100, 3 times 0, 4 times 0, 1, dot, dot, dot. Rupika, can you tell this answer?
Ma'am, it is non-terminating and non-repeating, so it's an irrational number.
Yes. See here, this is, though the digits 1 and 0 are there, but is there a same sequence getting repeated?
No, ma'am.
0. This is 1, 0. Then after that should be 1, 0, but it comes 0, 1. Now again 0, 0 are there. Again 0, 1 is there. Again 0, 0, 0, 0, but 1 again. So that means any one of the sequence is not getting repeated. The same sequence, including 0 and 1, will not get repeated. So this is non-terminating and as well as non-repeating. Therefore, it is irrational. Is that clear?
Yes,
rational, irrational numbers. Now next one. This number. Amrita?
Irrational.
Vishal? Vishal, can you tell? Unmute yourself. Yes, Vishal.
Ma'am, non-terminating and non-repeating. So it's a irrational number.
Very good. So it is non-terminating, also non-repeating. Though there is a 150, but the sequence is not proper. there is a no proper sequence for these numbers. So therefore, this is non-terminating and non-repeating also. So this kind of expansions we call as irrational numbers. Is that clear? What do you mean by rational and irrational now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today, so yes. Anyone has a doubt? Anyone, any doubts you have? No doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Then we will stop here. If you have completed this, you can leave the meeting.
Ma'am, do we have any homework?
Homework right now, this is only part. Yeah, I will send you about finding out rational and irrational number. Okay, one second, okay, otherwise you write it down. One second. I have the questions, write it down. Completed this part? Okay, so what you're doing is first find the decimal expansion. So question, write down the question. Find decimal expansions of following numbers and write whether they are terminating or non-terminating. Or repeating, recurring, that type of a decimal expansion, so you have to find out. So first is 13 by 80, 7 by 24, 5 by 12, 31 by 375, 16 by 125, 5 by 8. Okay, for this many questions.
Ma'am, is it 3 by 11?
Yeah, 3 by 11. Okay. So this converts first, find the decimal expansion and check whether they are terminating or non-terminating. And if it is non-terminating, whether it is repeating or non-repeating. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, one more thing. One more question, a simple question. Second, classify as rational or irrational. This is only one line answer you have to write with reason. First one is square root of 3 by 81. Square root of 361. 1.44 square root. Root 6. 2 by 3, root 6. 4.1276. Next is 1.23, 2 double 3, 2 triple 3, so on. Okay, these numbers. That's it, fine. Okay, So these many questions you can complete. Fine. If anyone has written down completed, they can leave.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.